Today's topic is polynomials. So in this topic we will be seeing what is polynomial, types of polynomial, based on numbers, then we will be seeing degree of a polynomial, then types of polynomial, based on degree, so today we will see what is a polynomial, types of polynomial based on the numbers, degree of a polynomial, the types of polynomial based on the degree of a polynomial, and then we will be seeing zero of a polynomial. After this, we'll be seeing graphs of polynomials, and then we'll be seeing relationship of zeros and the coefficients. And finally, we'll be seeing the division algorithm. An algebraic expression, in which the powers of the variable are all non-negative integers or whole numbers, are called polynomials. An algebraic expression in which the powers of the variable are non-negative integers. An algebraic expression in which the powers of the variable are non-negative integers or whole numbers . They are called polynomials. Examples of polynomials: examples which are not polynomials. For example, Examples of polynomials which are not polynomials. So, examples of polynomials which are not polynomials, there are 3 root x minus 5 is not a polynomial because the power of the variable x here is a fraction, it is not a whole number. Same way, 2 minus 5 by x plus 7x is not a polynomial here because in the second term the power of the variable is a negative integer. Thus, we saw what is a polynomial, the examples of polynomials, and which are not the polynomial examples. After this, we are going to see the types of polynomials based on the numbers. Types of polynomials. Based on numbers. First one, if you see monomial. It is based on the number of terms. Monomial. A polynomial having only one term. A polynomial having only one term is called a monomial. Example, 2x squared y is a monomial.
Is 2 plus 1.
That is, it is the sum of the power of the variables in the monomial. The degree of a monomial is the sum of the power of the variables in the monomial. So here, there are two variables, x and y. The power of the variable is, variable x is 2 and that of y is 1. So the degree is 2 plus 1, that is equal to 3. The degree of the monomial 2x square y is 3. Similarly, let's have another example. Pi by 3 u v square w. In this monomial, there are three variables u, v and w. The power of the variable u is 1, that of v is 2 and that of w is 1. So, the degree is 1 plus 2 plus 1. Power of the variable u is 1, power of variable v is 2 and that of w is 1. So, 1 plus 2 plus 1 is 4. So, the degree of the monomial, this monomial is 4. Knowing this, we'll come to know about the degree of a polynomial. So now we can say what is the degree of a polynomial. It is the greatest degree of all the terms in a polynomial. It is the greatest degree of the terms in a polynomial. Okay. Example. The greatest degree of all the terms in a polynomial. So, the greatest of the degrees of all the terms in a polynomial is called degree of a polynomial. Example, you can have of example level. Example has, suppose polynomial has p of x is equal to 3x squared minus 5xy squared z plus 2. Now, this polynomial may, kitne terms hai? 3 terms hai. 1, 2, 3. There are 3 terms in this polynomial. Okay. The degree of the term 3x squared is 2. And again here, one more monomial, the second term, 5xy squared z, the degree is 4, and here the degree is 0. So, that means the highest degree is 4. So, therefore, the degree of this polynomial is 4. Here, degree of 3x squared is 2. Degree of minus 5xy squared z is 4, as we have seen here, degree of the monomial. And degree of 2 is 0. So thus, the highest of the degrees is 4. So therefore, the degree of the polynomial P of x is 4. So, I hope you understood how to get the degree of a polynomial. After this, knowing the degree of the polynomial, we will know types of polynomials based on the degree of the polynomial. Types of polynomials. Based on degree of the polynomial. Now, in this, first let's see zero polynomials. zero polynomial. What is a zero polynomial? A polynomial in which all the coefficients are zero. For example, P of x is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. P of x equal to ax square plus bx plus c. This is, the coefficients are a, b, and c. So, if a is equal to b is equal to c is equal to 0, if all the coefficients a, b, and c are equal to 0, then the polynomial p of x is a zero polynomial. Understood? So, a polynomial in which all the coefficients are 0. So, for example, if you have a polynomial p of x is equal to ax square plus bx plus c, then this is the coefficients a, b, and c are all zeros, then the polynomial is a 0 polynomial. What about the degree of a 0 polynomial? The degree of 0 polynomial is not defined. Is not defined. The degree of zero polynomial is not defined. Degree is defined nahi hai. So just now we saw what is zero polynomial and what is its degree. Then comes constant polynomial. Now let's know what is a constant polynomial. What will be the degree of a constant polynomial? Yes, it will be 0. So, the degree, if the degree of a polynomial is 0, if the degree of the polynomial is 0, then it is called a zero polynomial. Zero polynomial. Okay? So, constant polynomial ke liye degree rahega zero. Example, f of x is equal to 5. So, ये polynomial in x है और it is equal to 5. So, 5 is a constant. It has the degree. To get the degree, you can write this as f of x is equal to 5 x to the power 0. As 5 is equal to 5 into 1. 5 को हम 5 into 1 लिख सकते हैं. So, f of x is equal to 5 x to the power 0, we can write it. This 1, we can write as x power 0. Okay? So, thus, the degree of a constant polynomial is 0. After this comes linear polynomial. Now, can you tell me what is the degree of a linear polynomial? Yes, it is 1. So the degree, if the degree of the polynomial is 1, it is called a linear polynomial. Degree is 1. If the degree of the polynomial is 1, then it is called a linear polynomial. So it can be written as p of x is equal to ax plus b is a general form of a linear polynomial. Okay, so in this you find that the degree of the polynomial is 1, so it is called a linear polynomial where a is not equal to 0 and a and b belong to real numbers. So this is called a linear polynomial. Same way, what is the polynomial of degree 2? Yes? It is? What is the polynomial of degree 2 called? It is called quadratic polynomial. So quadratic polynomial is of degree 2. Example, p of x is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. Here, the highest power of the variable is 2, so degree is 2, hence it is a quadratic polynomial. Here, a, b, c belongs to R and a is not equal to 0. So that's a quadratic polynomial. Similarly, we can have cubic polynomial. Here the degree of the polynomial is 3. Then it is called a cubic polynomial. Example, p of x is equal to ax cubed plus bx squared plus cx plus b. Ax cubed plus bx squared plus cx plus b is the standard form of a cubic polynomial where a, b, c, d belongs to R and a is not equal to 0. So thus we have some type. Again, if suppose the degree is 4, then the type of polynomial is called biquadratic polynomial. Biquadratic polynomial, the degree is 4. Example of the standard form of the biquadratic polynomial is ax power 4 plus bx cubed plus cx squared plus dx plus e, where a, b, c, d, e belongs to all real numbers and a should not be equal to 0. So thus, we have two types of the polynomials based on the degree of the polynomial. Then, let's come to the next concept, that is zero of the polynomial. Zero of a polynomial. Zero of a polynomial, as the name suggests, the zero. Okay. Let's see. If p of x is equal to x plus 3 is a polynomial, linear polynomial. Okay. Now, in this, if x is equal to, let us substitute, the x is equal to minus 3, then p of minus 3 will be equal to minus 3 plus 3 and that is equal to 0. That means for the value of the variable x, minus 3, if you substitute, then the value of the polynomial becomes 0. So from this you can say that if for any value of the variable, the value of the polynomial becomes 0, then it is called 0 of the polynomial.
that
the value of
the variable for which the value of polynomial becomes zero. Let us first see the graph of a linear polynomial. Linear polynomial, as we have seen just now, it is a polynomial of degree 1, okay, and its standard form is ax plus b. So p of x is equal to ax plus b is a linear polynomial. Okay. Now, let us find out the zero of the polynomial. To find out the zero of the polynomial, we have to equate it to zero, because the polynomial becomes zero. The value for which, the value of the variable for which the polynomial becomes zero is called zero of the polynomial. So that means the polynomial becomes zero, that means ax plus b should be equal to zero to get the zero of the polynomial. So ax is equal to minus b, or x is equal to minus b upon a. The zero of the polynomial is minus b by a. Then that means that is the solution of this equation x plus b equal to zero. Now on the graph, always a linear polynomial gives a line on the graph, a straight line on the graph. So it may be x-axis, y-axis, origin. So the line may intersect the x-axis at one point, and the solution will be minus b by a, comma 0. So a linear polynomial on the graph gives a straight line on the graph. So a linear polynomial always gives a straight line on the graph. It intersects the x-axis. It intersects the x-axis in only
This is about the linear polynomial. The second one, let's go to quadratic polynomial. Let us see how a graph looks like for a quadratic polynomial. A quadratic polynomial's standard form is P of x is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c. This quadratic polynomial, the graph is a parabola. The graph for a quadratic polynomial is a parabola. That means it is a curve. It is not a straight line. Now, if a is less than 0, if a is less than 0, then the graph is a parabola opening upwards. A greater than 0, let's take first. If A, here A is the coefficient of x squared in the quadratic polynomial. So if A is greater than 0, then the graph is a parabola which opens upwards. Secondly, if a is less than 0, then the graph is a parabola opening downwards. The graph is a parabola opening downwards. And thirdly, the vertex of a parabola is given by minus b by 2a, comma minus b by 4a, where d is equal to b square minus 4ac, called discriminant. So this we have seen, it depends upon the coefficient of x squared, that is a. If a is greater than 0, then the parabola opens upwards. If a is less than 0, it opens downwards. And the vertex of the parabola is given by the coordinates minus b by 2a and minus b by 4a, where b is equal to b square minus 4ac. So, let us see, in the first condition, if a is greater than 0, and the discriminant D is greater than 0. Let us see for the conditions A greater than 0 and B greater than 0. What the graph looks like? Graph of a quadratic polynomial looks like. The graph will be like this. And since b is greater than 0, it will intersect the x-axis in two points. So, it will be like this. The graph opens upwards because b is greater than 0. or two distinct zero for the quadratic polynomial, and hence it will intersect the x-axis in two points, two distinct points. It means that if A is less than 0 and B is greater than 0, in this case, the parabola opens downwards, and will intersect the x-axis in two distinct points. Here A is less than 0. So we saw two conditions. When A is greater than 0 and B is greater than 0, the graph looks this way. And for the condition A less than 0, D greater than 0, the graph opens downwards as well as intersecting the x-axis in two distinct points. What if D is equal to 0? If D is equal to 0, again, we have two conditions. Let's have A less than 0 and B greater than 0. So in this case, the graph will be like this. It will be touching the x-axis. It will be just touching the x-axis, the vertex, at a point, and it will be opening downwards. That if D is equal to 0 and A is greater than 0, then the graph will look like this. A is greater than 0, the graph will open upwards, and D is equal to 0 means it will have only one point. It will be touching the x-axis at one point. So this will be the graph when D is equal to 0 and A is greater than 0. So this is about the graph of quadratic polynomials. I hope that's clear. Then, graphs of cubic polynomials. The graphs of cubic polynomials are also curves and they intersect. We have the graphs of cubic polynomials are also the curves that intersect the x-axis in at least one point, or at the max they will intersect in three points. Okay? So that is how we have seen the graphs of the polynomials. Okay? Then let's come to the relationship of zeros and the coefficients of the polynomials.
the relationship of the zeros and the coefficients of the polynomial. Let's start with linear polynomial. For a linear polynomial, the standard form is p of x is equal to ax plus b. Equating it to 0, ax plus b equal to 0, x is equal to minus b by a. So, 0 of p of x is minus b by a. 0 of p of x is minus b by a. Equating x plus b to 0, we get the 0 of the polynomial, that is x equal to minus b by a. So, the 0 of the polynomial p of x is minus b by a. Now, this is equal to minus of, now look at b here, b is a constant term. So, minus of constant term by a. A is the coefficient of x. Thus, the 0 of the polynomial p of x, of a linear polynomial p of x, is minus b by a. It is, in terms of coefficient, it is minus of constant term by coefficient of x. Secondly, let's see the relation of zeros and coefficients of a quadratic polynomial. The standard form of a quadratic polynomial, p of x is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c, where a is not equal to 0, where we see being real numbers. For this, we know at max there are two zeros for a quadratic polynomial. So let alpha and beta be the zeros of p of x is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c. Let alpha and beta be the two zeros of the quadratic polynomial ax squared plus bx plus c. Then ax squared plus bx plus c will be equal to k into x minus alpha into x minus beta, where k is a constant polynomial, it is a constant factor, okay, of the polynomial, and x minus alpha and x minus beta are the linear polynomials for the quadratic polynomial a squared plus bx plus c, okay, because alpha and beta are the zeros. So, ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to k into x minus alpha into x minus beta. Okay. So, that implies ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to k into, multiplying this, we get x squared minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. A squared plus bx plus c is equal to k into x squared minus alpha plus beta x plus alpha beta. But then these two we get there. Okay. Now on comparing of the coefficients on both the sides, we get alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, which is equal to, now if you see in the quadratic polynomial a squared plus bx plus c, b is the coefficient of x and a is the coefficient of x squared. So we can write it as minus of coefficient of x
by coefficient of x squared. So this is the relationship between the zeros of the polynomial and their coefficients. So sum of zeros is equal to minus the coefficient of x by coefficient of x squared. Same thing, the alpha beta, on comparison as we have seen, alpha beta is will be equal to c by a, and that is equal to c here is the constant term and a again the coefficient of x squared. So if it is constant term by coefficient of x squared. So we have seen for quadratic polynomial, standard form being this. Okay. So if we see the factors, if alpha and beta are the zeros of the quadratic polynomial x squared plus bx plus c, then the factors are x minus alpha and x minus beta. So another the constant factor we have taken as k. Okay. Then this is equal to k into x minus alpha into x minus beta. So usse humko aa raha hai k into x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. On comparing both sides the coefficients, we get alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, which is equal to this, and alpha beta equal to. Okay. Then coming to cubic polynomial. So, in the case of a cubic polynomial, the standard form, as you know, standard form is p of x is equal to ax cubed plus bx squared plus cx plus d. A, b, c, d are all real numbers and a not equal to 0. So, in this case, at maximum there can be 3 zeros. So, let us consider the 3 zeros as, let alpha, beta and gamma be the 3 zeros. Of p of x of the cubic polynomial, then p of x will be equal to k into x minus alpha into x minus beta into x minus gamma. Or ax cubed plus bx squared plus cx plus d is equal to k into, now multiplying these 3, we get x cubed minus alpha plus beta plus gamma x squared plus alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha into x minus alpha beta gamma. On expansion or on multiplying these 3 factors, x minus alpha, x minus beta and x minus gamma, we get this. Now again comparing on both the sides, we get so what will you get? Alpha plus beta plus gamma will be equal to minus b by a. If you compare alpha plus beta plus gamma, that is sum of the zeros, will be minus b by a. That is equal to, now just look at the standard form of it, b is the coefficient of x squared and a is the coefficient of x cubed. So we can write it as minus of coefficient of x squared by coefficient of x cubed. Similarly, alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha will be equal to c by a. Will be equal to c by a. Now c by a, c is the coefficient of x and a is the coefficient of x cubed. So we can write it as quotient of x by quotient of x cube. And finally, alpha, beta, gamma, the product of the zeros is equal to minus e by a. So here, again, come back to the standard form of the cubic polynomial. T is the constant and a is the coefficient of x cube. So it is equal to minus of constant term by coefficient of x cube. So these are the relations of the zeros and the coefficients of the polynomial. Okay. So at last, let's come to the division algorithm of the polynomials. Division algorithm. Division algorithm of the polynomials. We are quite familiar with the division rule with the numbers. Okay. The division rule says whenever we divide, we come to the conclusion for the division rule as dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. This is what we come across every time whenever we divide one number by the another number. The same is followed for the polynomials. The same rule follows for the polynomials. Let f of x and g of x be any polynomials, any two polynomials, let f of x and g of x be any two polynomials with g of x not equal to 0, and then when f of x is divided by g of x, we can get polynomials q of x and r of x. If p of x and g of x are any two polynomials with g of x not equal to 0, then when f of x is divided by g of x, if we are dividing f of x by g of x, then we can get polynomials q of x and r of x such that f of x is equal to g of x into q of x plus r of x. This is the division algorithm. Here, the remainder r of x will be equal to 0. R of x will be equal to 0, or degree of r of x polynomial r of x is less than degree of g of x. The degree of the polynomial r of x should be less than the degree of the divisor g of x. This is the division algorithm for the polynomial. With this, we conclude the topic polynomials. Then, in today's revision, we have to go for pair of linear equations. in two places. So now we are going to start another topic, pair of linear equations in two variables.
These two linear equations in two variables taken together form a pair of linear equations.
system of linear equations in two variables. So a pair of is set to form a system of linear equations. In two variables. Now, solution. So let's now go to solution of a pair of linear equations. Of a pair of linear equations. Is called the solution. The values of x and y will be the solution of the equation. Knowing the solution, let us see the type of solutions. One is consistent. consistent system of equations. Now, what do you mean by consistent system of equations? If a pair of linear equations in two variables had at least one solution, if a pair of linear equations in two variables has at least one solution, then it is called consistent system of equations. Then it is called consistent system of equations. That inconsistent system of equations, if a pair of linear equations has no solution, if a system of equations has no solution, if a system of equations has no solution, then it is called inconsistent system of equations. Let us see now the graphical representation of the linear equations in two variables. Graphical representation of linear equations in two variables. First, the linear pair. First one, if you see, a pair of linear equations has got two linear equations. That means we will get two lines on the graph. We get two lines on the ground. Now these two lines can be intersecting, or they can be parallel to each other, or they may lie one over another, or they may coincide. So first, the intersecting lines. When are the two lines intersecting? If A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2, then the two lines will intersect at a point. If A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2, then the two lines will intersect at a point on the graph and the point of intersection is the solution. So you see, first condition, the two lines intersect. When do they intersect? The condition is for the equation A1x plus B1y plus C1 equal to 0 and A2x plus B2y plus C2 equal to 0. If A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2, then the two lines will intersect at a point on the graph. And the point of intersection is called the solution of the two equations. Thus, there is a unique solution
the graph looks like this. X-axis, y-axis, one line, line L, and another line M. They both intersect at a point P, which is the solution of the equation.
Secondly, the lines are parallel if A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2.
You can see the condition.
If A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2, then the two lines will not intersect . That is, they are parallel. Thus, this system of equations has no solution. The graph will look like this, and the lines will be parallel to each other. So in this case, the condition is A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2, then the lines are parallel, and we say that the system of equations has no solution. And let us see the third condition, that is, the lines are coincident. Lines are coincident. Coincident lines. If A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. If all the ratios are equal, then the lines, the two lines, will coincide. Two lines will coincide. If A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2 equal to C1 by C2, then thus the system of equations have infinitely many solutions. So thus we can see that if A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2 equal to C1 by C2, then in this case the lines will coincide, that is, they will fall one above another, or we can say that there is a single line for both the equations. Thus the system of equations will have infinitely many solutions. So in this, you see the graph looks like this. And there is a single line. L and M, both the equations represent a single line, and hence
there will be infinitely many solutions. All the points on the line are the solution.
So we saw the graph representations and the solutions on the of the lines on the graph. Now let us see the algebraic method of solutions. Algebraic methods of solutions.
Then the first method is substitution method.
First method is substitution method,
where you substitute one variable into another for another.
Like example,
let us have an example. X plus 2y equal to minus 1
and 2x minus y equal to 3.
So this is a pair of linear equations.
Now you see, if you take the second equation,
this is the second equation from equation 2, with that y is equal to 2x minus 3. From the equation 2, we get the variable y is equal to 2x minus 3.
Let us take, consider this as 3. Equation 3. Now, substituting this y equal to 2x minus 3 in the equation 1.
Y equal to 2x minus 3 in 1, in the equation 1.
In the equation 1, it is this.
So it is x plus 2 into, in place of y, we are going to substitute the value of y. 2x minus 3 is equal to minus 1. Let's simplify. X plus 4x minus 6 is equal to minus 1. So on simplification, x plus 5x is on the other. 4x, 5x minus 6 plus 1 equal to 0. So 5x minus 5 equal to 0, or 5x equal to 5 and x equal to 1.
So we get 5x equal to 5, and that implies x is equal to 1. Getting the value of x, substitute it in the equation 3. Put x equal to 1 in equation 3.
We get y is equal to 2 into 1 minus 3. So y is equal to minus 1. Thus, we get the solution is 1 and minus 1.
X equal to 1, y equal to minus 1 is the solution of the two equations, or a pair of linear equations. Second method. The second method is elimination by equating the coefficients.
Elimination by equating the coefficients. Example, let's take the same example, x plus 2y and 2x minus y is equal to 3. Taking the
example as pair of linear equations given to you.
Now, as the name, the method says elimination by equating the coefficients. So, we need to equate the coefficients which has to be eliminated. One of the variables has to be eliminated. Okay. So, let's equate the variable y, the coefficients of the variable y. This is equation 1 and equation 2. Now, equating these two, so multiply equation 2 by 2, we get 4x minus 2y is equal to 6. We have multiplied the equation 2 by 2, we get 4x minus 2y equal to 6. Then, now adding, let this be equation 3, adding 1 and 3, adding equation 1 and 3, we get. Now why are we adding? We need to eliminate the variable y. This is minus 2y, this is plus 2y, already the coefficients are same. If we add, it will be eliminated. So x plus 2y equal to minus 1 and 4x minus 2y equal to 6. On adding, we get 5x, this is cancelled, is equal to 5. The x is equal to 1. So we get x is equal to 1. Okay. Then, put this in any one variable. Put this value of the variable in any one of these equations to get the value of the variable y. Put x is equal to 1 in equation 2. We get 2 into 1 minus y is equal to 3. 2 minus y is equal to 3. Minus y is equal to minus 1. So we get minus y is equal to 1. That implies y is equal to minus 1. Thus, the solution is 1 minus 1. So x equal to 1, y equal to minus 1 is the solution. 5. The method of elimination by equating the coefficients. The third method which we are going to see is the cross multiplication method, which you know already. Third one is cross multiplication method. Cross multiplication method. Let's have the example. A pair of linear equations as x plus 2y equal to minus 1 and 2x minus y equal to 3. So, in this, first we'll find out the ratios a1 by a2, b1 by b2, and c1 by c2. So, we get a1 is equal to 1 in the first linear equation, b1 is equal to 2, and c1 is equal to 1. This first we have to write it as x plus 2y plus 1 equal to 0 in the standard form. Writing this equation in the standard form, x plus 2y plus 1 equal to 0 and 2x minus y minus 3 equal to 0. So we have a1 equal to 1, b1 equal to 2 and c1 is equal to 1. a2 is equal to minus, a2 is equal to 2, b2 is equal to minus 1 and c2 is equal to minus 3. There, x is equal to b1 c2 minus b2 c1 by a1 b2 minus a2 b1.
The value of x will be given by the formula b1 c2 minus b2 c1 by a1 b2 minus a2 b1, and y will be equal to c1 a2 minus c2 a1 by a1 b2 minus a2 b1. Now we can find out the solution. So that implies x is equal to b1 c2, b1 into c2, 2 into minus 3, minus b2 c1, minus 1 into 1, by a1 b2, a1 into b2, 1 into minus 1, minus a2 into b1, 2 into 2. That is, we get minus 6 plus 1 by minus 1 minus 4. That is equal to minus 5 upon minus 5 equal to 1. So we get x is equal to 1. Similarly, we can get the value of y. So y is equal to c1 into a2, 1 into 2, minus c2 a1, minus 3 into 1, by a1 b2, 1 into minus 1, minus 2 into 2. We get y is equal to 2 plus 3 upon minus 1 minus 4. We get y is equal to 5 upon minus 5, or y is equal to minus 1. So we get the solution as x equal to 1 and y equal to minus 1. So the method of cross multiplication, we have the value x is equal to b1 c2 minus b2 c1 by a1 b2 minus a2 b1, and the variable y is equal to c1 a2 minus c2 a1 by a1 b2 minus a2 b1. This can also be written as x by b1 c2 minus b2 c1 is equal to y by c1 a2 minus c2 a1 is equal to 1 by a1 b2 minus a2 b1. Or this further can be written as x by b1 b2 c1 c2 equal to y by c1 c2 a1 a2 equal to 1 by a1 a2 b1 b2, and then cross multiply and subtract. So therefore it is known as the cross multiplication method. So with this we have completed today's topic. Thank you all.